Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about flow rollback element. So if you have a flow where you have multiple database operations going on, you might have already faced a problem where one of your database operations failed and that made the entire flow fail. But what about any previous database operations? When a flow transaction failed, its pending record changes were always saved to the database even if one of the flow elements failed in the transaction. But that's not good, right? Because what you really want is to cancel and roll back all pending changes in the screen flow. That is what I'm going to show you in today's video, how the rollback element will help you to cancel and roll back all pending record changes in screen flow. So without any further delay, let's see the example. Before I start, a small request to all of you, please subscribe to my channel as I keep on publishing new content on Salesforce, web technologies, cloud, AI here. So no more talking, let's jump to the Salesforce org and see the example. So here I am in my Salesforce org. I've already created this flow, but let me explain what this flow is doing. So it's basically a screen flow. The first element is basically where I'm asking for first name and last name. This is the contact first name and last name. And then few information from the case object like the case origin, description and the priority. This is something I'm capturing on the first screen element. And then with the first name and last name, what I'm doing, I'm searching for an existing contact where the first name matches with the contact first name and the last name matches with the contact last name. This for contact first name and last name are actually the input variables which is coming from the first screen here. This is the contact first name and this is the contact last name. I'm searching for a contact and then there is a decision element whether the contact found or not. It means like, you know, whatever first name and last name I'm giving, with that first name and last name, is there any contact present in the org or not? If there is a contact present in the org, what I'm trying to do here, I'm basically in the case record, the case contact ID, I'm making the existing contact ID. If there is no contact present, I'm going to create a contact where the first name and last name are the same. Account ID, I'm just putting it a hard-coded. This is not a best practice, just but for this demo and for making it very simple, I'm just putting a hard-coded value. But please don't do that in your real example. So here I'm creating a contact and then this is creating a contact. And then what are the newly contact ID? I'm assigning that newly contact ID into the single case, in the case contact ID. And finally, I'm creating the case record. So now let's debug this flow and see how it works. So I'm starting the debug and it is asking me for the first name and last name. So let's give a name as hello world as the first name, hello as the first name, world as the last name, case origin as email, put some description, let's say testing, and then priority as high and click on next. What is doing actually, as you can see here, first this is a screen element, there is no contact found. So if there is no contact found, then it's actually creating the contact and then assigning the contact ID with the single case and finally creating the case. So let's go to the org and see. So here I am in the org, and if I open this Salesforce.com account, I can see that in the related contact there is a new contact created called hello world. At the same time, let me bring the case tab here. And now if I go to the case, I can see that there should be a new case created, 1009. And as you can see here, this is the case owner and the case contact is hello world. And the subject is testing, description is testing and all this thing, right? So far so good. Now, in the case record, I've created a validation rule where the validation rule is if you choose a priority in the case, then your description cannot be blank. So when you choose a priority of the case, you need to put something in the description. So now let's run this flow. And this time I'm going to choose the first name as James and last name as Bond. Case origin, I'll keep the description as blank intentionally and priority I'll choose as high. And I'll click on next. But this time the flow failed. The flow failed because of the validation rule, which is expected. But the flow failed at this node. But even before reaching this node, there is a node where the transaction, some database operation happened to create a contact. And we don't want that. What we really want, if the flow failed, all transactions should be rolled back. We don't want the contact to be created. So how we can do that? The way to do that is using that new rollback element. So we are thinking this is a node where it can fail. So what we need to do, right click and click on add fault path. Add fault path. So the moment you do that, this is your fault path, right? In the fault path on this one, you need to add a rollback element. So rollback records. So rollback all records and click on save. Once the rollback is done, you basically want to present a message to your user that something wrong happened. So let's put a screen element. Error message. And here, let's put a display text. Something wrong happened. Let's make it a lit and bold. And this is a message that will be displayed. Instead of previously we saw a message that is basically a standard Salesforce Flow error message, but we want to display some our custom message, right? So now what you need to do after this error message, you want user to come back to the screen. So what you need to do, click on this one and connect to elements and then choose this one. So what will happen after this error message, your user will come back to the screen. So let's save that and activate. And this time I'll run again. I'll give the same example. James Bond. I'll keep the description blank again. Hi, but this is what will happen now. Instead of that Salesforce standard flow message, it actually displayed our custom message, and clicking on next, it took us to the previous screen. Now we can give correct information like email, put some description like James Bond's case and click on next, and it will actually create the case. So now if I go to the contact, I'll go to this record and I can see there is a new contact created as James Bond. And if I go to the cases, I can see there is a new case created where the owner is James Bond and the description is James Bond case. So this is how you can use the rollback elements in your fault path inside Flow. And that way you should be able to present your user with a custom error message and then handle the fault scenarios and also let Flow do all the rollback of your pending transactions. So that's all. I hope you really enjoyed today's content. Show some love by giving this video a big thumbs up. And finally, if you think there is someone you know who might benefit from this video, please consider sharing it. Word of mouth really does wonder. And finally, thanks for being a part of Technical Potpourri community. Until next time, keep exploring and stay curious. Thank you. Bye-bye.